Hi viewers, welcome to LMS Solution. Today we are going to see about a design of bug bus converter with the PID controller. The bug bus converter can operate in step up mode or step down mode, and the output voltage polarity is negative in the bug bus converter. Okay, so first we have to see about the design of the LNC for the bug bus converter. So this is an equation used for designing a bug bus converter. So here we need to here we are going to design 250 watts bug bus converter. So the P nothing but the rating of the bug bus converter, and then second one is input minimum voltage we are consider as 27 volt. The input maximum voltage we are consider as 32 volt. The operating voltage of the bug bus converter here we are consider as 30.7 volt, and then the output of the voltage requirement we are consider as minus 12 volt, and then this is output maximum output current of the bug bus converter. So by using this formula P divided by V naught, we can calculate that the maximum output current of the bug bus converter. So this is the ripple inductor current of the bug bus converter, and then this is the input voltage ripple, and then this is output voltage ripple. So here we are consider the switching frequency for the bug bus converter is 10 kilohertz, and then the ESRCI and ESRCN are nothing but the equivalent series resistance for input capacitor and output capacitor. So next you have to calculate duty cycle for that bug bus converter. So next you have to calculate L1, and then you have to calculate C1 and C2. Sorry, C1 and C0. The C1 is input capacitor and C0 is output capacitor. So here we are going to use only two things. One is L1 and C0 after running this program. Okay, so here I'm going to run this program. So here we can here you are going to use L1 and C0 for creating the Simulink model of the bug bus converter. So next you have to create that bug bus converter in the Simulink. So for that we need a DC voltage source. So type DC voltage source, and then you can use this one. So here the voltage I am going to use 30.7 volt. So and then we need IGBT diode combination, that means power electronic switch. So I am going to use the power electronic switch here, and then we need the inductor. So here I am going to use series RLC branch, and then I am going to rotate this one. So this is going to act as inductor, filter inductor. So here just you choose L alone, and then you can copy this value from here. So next we need diode, right? So you can take the diode, this diode, and then you can rotate in opposite direction and connect here, and then we need capacitor, filter capacitor. So here you can change the branch type is C, and then you can copy this value, this will C0. Okay, copy this value and then paste it here. So next we need load, right? So here you can use the same element, and then you can change to R. Okay, then next you have to calculate the value for R. So here we are consider the power is 250. Okay, so you can calculate the maximum load resistance or resistor, which is equal to V out star V out, so divided by V. Okay, so the value is 0.5760. okay, so here I'm going to take 0.6. okay, at the round value I'm going to take 0.6 ohms, and then here you need to change IGBT with the diode combination. Okay, so here I'm going to use IGBT with diode, and then we need a PWM generator. So I'm going to use PWM DC to DC generator, and then it's going to be connected to the gating of the IGBT diode model. And then the duty cycle, right? Here the duty cycle is 0.3077, right? So here I'm going to use some constant log to provide the duty cycle. So I'm going to provide duty cycle in 0.3007, and I'm going to measure the output voltage. So just go to this voltage measurement, and also I'm going to measure the current and the load. And then I'm going to use scope. So here we need to measure three parameters: load voltage, current, and power. So I'm going to use three layout. So here I'm going to measure voltage and current and power. So next we need this, that means we need another block, nothing but power GUI, because it consists of the power system block set. So we must use that power GUI block. So everything is created, that means bug bus converter is created in the Simulink model. So next I am going to test the system. Okay, now I am going to test the system. And one more thing, we need to change another parameter. This called, so here we need to change to 10^3, okay, 10 kilohertz. So here you can see that the output voltage is maintained around as more than 12 volt, right? Okay. But it's nearer to 12 volt. It's maintained around 12 point or -13 volt. So as for design, it should be maintained at -12 volt, right? So for that we are going for a closed loop control. So for that we are going to use PID controller here. So here I'm going to use summing block and rotate. The load voltage is connected here, and then I'm going to change to minus plus. Next you need to use constant block. So here I'm going to use the reference voltage is -12, and then here I'm going to use PID controller. And I'm going to connect this PID controller output in the PWM generator. And here I'm going to choose PI controller. So here I'm not tuned the PI controller. So let's see the result of this system. Now we can see that we not get any results because we are not tuned the PI controller. So we must tune the PI controller first. So that is very easy. Just you go to PI controller. And then you can go into click this one, tune. That means after clicking tune button, you can see that PID tuner application in the MATLAB. So next you got to click plant and then click identify new plant, and then you can click get IO data and then click simulate data. And here I'm going to provide the offset equal to 0.15. And then here I'm going to use amplitude equal to 0.3, and then I'm going to simulate the model. So when simulating this model, it will be simulated for 2 times. That means we are giving input for the PWM generator, and then we are collecting the data in the input side of the PID controller. That is called error between actual voltage and reference voltage. So that is going to be considered as identification data. Okay. Then we initially we are providing 0.15 duty cycle. After 5 seconds, we are providing 0.45 duty cycle, and then it collect the data according that duty cycle we are providing to that PWM generator. So second time simulation is going on. After second simulation completion, right? We are able to see this data here, identification data. And then you need to apply that data, and then you got to further go for tuning process. So I think simulation is almost completed. Yeah, so now it's almost completed. Here you can see that. So this is the collected data or identification data. Just you got to apply here and close. So and then you can see that the green is the identification data, that means collected data. So blue color is identified data. So we are going to identify the plant. Our plant, that means the combination of boost converter with the PA controller, right? So for that you have to create some transfer function in order to tune that PID controller. So here I'm going to use auto estimate concept in order to identify the transfer function. So here K divided by T1S plus 1. So going to be considered as a transfer function. So here you can see that the green and blue will be superimposed to each other. Okay. So now I'm going to apply this system. So here you can see that this is a T1T response of the system. And then you can see here, right? This is the value for KP and KA. So KP equal to minus 0.01572, KA equal to minus 0.0677. So next I'm going to update the block. So once update the block, you can see here, right? So this is a value obtained from that PID tuner app in the MATLAB. So now I'm going to simulate the system. So now we are going to check the results. So now you can see that the voltage is maintained at minus 12 volt. Okay, so it having some ripple, right? Ripple is around only plus or minus 0.1 volt, right? So it maintained at minus 12 volt as per our tuning of PID controller. So just I'm going to close this one. So this is a way of tuning a PID controller for a buck boost converter. So next I'm going to check the result with the step change in input, right? So it's a step change in reference input. So here I'm going to use step, and then I'm going to connect that step here. So initially I'm going to make the reference voltage equal to minus 12 volt, and then I'm going to make the final value equal to minus 10 volt. So that means we are changing the reference voltage from minus 12 to 10, minus 10 volt at a time, after time of 5 seconds, right? And then you have to check the response of the system, whether the system is working or not with that PID controller. Now the system maintained at minus 12 volt after 5 seconds. You can see that after 5 seconds, right, that actual voltage changed to minus 10 volt as per the reference voltage command. So the PID controller, it track that reference voltage effectively. Okay, so this is a working of buck boost converter with the PID controller. Thanks for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for notification about upcoming videos. Thank you so much. Bye bye.